What's up, world? Dallas Thomas here with Gadget Hacks. Today I'm going to show you four new Android apps from indie devs. Now I'm always scrolling through forums looking for apps that fix something or give you new functionality. When I find one, I write an article about it, and it's always framed as how to solve XYZ problem. But a lot of the apps I find don't work with that formula. So instead of just scrolling past those, I'm going to start showing them to you guys every week. The other thing is, these are mostly from independent developers, typically just a single person hoping to make it big in the Android community. So let's shine a light on them, right? First is an app called I Choose To, and it's from a Swiss developer by the name of Jonas. As with all these apps, you can find its Play Store link in the description below this video if you would like to download it. It's somewhat like Google's digital well-being feature or Apple's Screen Time, in that the goal is to help you keep your smartphone usage under control. Once you've gone through the setup process, you can pick out all the apps that you think you're wasting too much time in. Then, when you try to open one of those apps, you'll have to wait 10 seconds before it actually opens, and during that time, you can cancel out if you reconsider. You can even set it up to throw that same pop-up after you've been using the app for a certain amount of time. Pretty cool stuff. Now next is an app called Last Time from German developer Kazito Nuoz. The goal is to help you remember the last time you performed a task, like taking your pills or mowing the lawn. You can categorize events to make them easier to find, and then whenever you do that thing again, you can add it to that same initial event to keep a timeline history. If you want, you can even set up notifications for that event to remind you the next time you need to do whatever that is. Third is an app called Tetrd, that's T-E-T-R-D, and it's from Robin Christian Jusan out of the Philippines. It enables USB tethering if your carrier or manufacturer has disabled it, and it also can be a great workaround for people on plans that only offer limited wireless tethering. What's special about this is that unlike other no-root tethering apps, it uses USB accessory mode instead of ADB, which makes it easier to use in many cases and gives it the potential to be even faster. You'll need to install a client on your computer, but then you'll be able to share your phone's connection to your PC with minimal setup. And you can even reverse tether to extend your computer's connection over to your phone. Now last is Sorted, which is from The New Era, aka DroidLover123, out of India. It's for organizing things you have to come back to often, things that you need to remember. You start by setting up an arrangement, which is like a little box that contains things you want to manage. Then you fill those arrangements with things you need to remember or reference often. And because of this organization system, they will be much easier to find in the future. But for more content like this, be sure to check out our website over at gadgethacks.com. And as always, we'd appreciate it if you would like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel. So we'll see you again next time, folks. But until then, happy gadget hacking.